Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Hero to Superhero. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series Angular 0 to Hero in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I'm going to show you how we can create a generic toastr functionality which we can reuse in our entire application. For that, I have created an Angular application in which I have created a header component, a first component, and a second component. In routing module, you can see when the path is first, I'm showing the first component. And when the path is second, I'm showing the second component. And in header component, I have created two divs and routing to the respective pages. In app component, I have placed the header and I have a route routlet. And so when we preview, we can see this. In first page, I have a title and few buttons. And in second page also the same. Right now, the buttons are not functional. That is what we are going to complete. First, let's design the toast. So in app component, let me create a div. Let me add a class toast container. Inside that, let me add another div for toast content. Inside that, let me add a span to have an icon. And another span to have the actual toast message. Also, let me add some CSS. Let me add a close button and some CSS. Also, let me add a show toast flag and set it to false initially. And then in onInit, let me change that to true. And let me create a close toast function. And inside that, let me change that back to false. In the HTML, let me use ngif to show this div based on show toast. Also, let me add a click event to the close button and bind this close toast function. So now I can close the toast. Okay, the initial design is completed. As we need to make this toaster reusable, it is better to use a service. Let me create one service. Okay, service has been created. Inside service, let me create a showToast function. We need to have a mechanism to change the showToast boolean variable in app component. For that, let me create a behavior subject in the service. And inside showToast function, let me emit a value. In app component, let me inject the toaster service. And in onInit, let me subscribe to that behavior subject. And when the message is null, let me set the showToast variable as false. And otherwise, let me set it to true. And finally, let me inject the service in the first component. And inside showToast function, let me call the showToast from the service, so that it will emit the next value, and in app component, as we have subscribed, that will change the boolean value. And so we can see the toast. Okay, this is working. Let's customize this further. First, instead of hard coding the message in app component, let us get it from the actual component. For that, let me create a variable and bind it here. I'm getting this toast message from the subject. And in the service, instead of passing empty string, I can get it as a parameter and pass that message. And in first component, I can pass the actual message. Let me test it. Now we can see the message is changed. Actually, if I click any button, we can get the same toast. Let's customize that. In app component, let me introduce a new variable toaster time. In HTML, let me use ng class so that it will be dynamic. In first component, let's pass this type to service. And in service, let's get this type and set it in local storage. And in app component, let's get it from local storage and set the toaster type. Let me also change the CSS slightly. Now we can see different types of toast. Let us customize the icons based on the toaster type. For info and warn, let me adjust the padding slightly. Now looks good. Next, let us customize the position. Instead of showing this always in top left, let's make it dynamic. For that, let me introduce a new variable, toaster position. Like toaster type, let me also get the toaster position from local storage. In HTML, let me add few more classes dynamically based on toaster position. And let me also change the CSS. And in the service, let me create a new parameter for position and set it in local storage. This time, let's make this parameter optional. And let me default it to top right, so that if you are not passing any value, let it be top right. So in first component, now I can pass the position. If I change it to top left, we can see the toasts are displaying in the left top. We can use other values also. If I am not giving any value for position, it will show in the top right. And we can also do another customization. Instead of closing the toast manually, it will be good if it auto-close. For that, let me create a timer variable in toaster service. Let me also get an optional parameter to decide whether to auto-close or not. If auto-close, let me use setTimer to hide the toast after 4 seconds. For that, I can emit a null value. Let me also clear the existing timer, if any. Now in first component, let me pass the auto close as true and test this. Let me click and wait for 4 seconds. Yes, it is working. If needed, we can also customize this further. Instead of hard coding the auto close timer value, we can pass it dynamically. And finally, if we need to reuse this in another component, we just need to inject the service and use this one line of code in showToast function. That's it. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.